Hello everyone! Do you believe that science fiction can become a reality? If you're doubtful, just look around. The future is just around the corner, and technology is advancing much faster than we ever anticipated. According to hypotheses like the intelligence explosion, the moment when humanity creates artificial intelligence capable of self-improvement without human intervention, we might be on the brink of this phenomenon. Imagine a scenario where powerful AI starts improving itself, with each new generation becoming more powerful and appearing more quickly. And what if this moment is closer than it seems? Yes, AI is already moving beyond your browser and smart speakers. OpenAI has taken a step in this direction, presenting its first demo in collaboration with a startup called Figure, chosen to realize this dream. Now, as AI begins to interact with our world more physically, we are on the cusp of a new era of human-machine interaction. That's what we will be discussing today. Once again, you are on the Analog Vision channel. Give us a like in advance, subscribe to the channel, and hit the bell icon. Let's get started. Yes, you heard correctly. ChatGPT is no longer confined to your browser. Now it has arms, legs, a body, and a head. A real robot, no less. Although it's still a long way from behaving like R2-D2. It all started a year ago when entrepreneur and the founder of the startup Figure, Brett Adcock, and his company attracted the attention of major players in the robotics and AI market, including Boston Dynamics, Tesla, Google DeepMind, and others. Brett's goal? To create the world's first commercially available general-purpose humanoid robot. Brett might be a new name for us, but he is no novice, having already earned several hundred million dollars by the age of 35. Which he now spends on robots. By October 2023, the Figure 01 robot stood on its feet. This was the first time we saw this robot walking. By the way, it was taught to walk with balance in less than a year. That's impressive. In just 4 months, by mid-January this year, Figure signed its first commercial contract to use Figure 01 at a BMW automotive plant in North Carolina, USA. And in less than a month, in February, we already saw a video of Figure robot working in a warehouse. And then again, in less than a month, in March, OpenAI, creators of ChatGPT, invested in Figure and signed a cooperation agreement on March 1st to develop next-generation AI models for robots. Besides OpenAI, new investors include Jeff Bezos, Nvidia, Microsoft, Intel, and others. Oh, and they also founded something like a robotics alliance, but more on that later. At the heart of it all is GPT-4V, taking on key perception and communication functions. For reference, GPT-4V, or GPT-4 Vision, is an enhanced version of ChatGPT-4 that can analyze images and answer questions about them. This significantly improves its usability, since GPT-4 could only process text data until then. GPT-4V perceives sensor information and then transmits it to the robot, which converts this data into movement. All this is done with the help of Figure's neural networks, which ensure the robot's quick, precise, and agile movements. Let's take a look at demonstration.
Hey Figure 1, what do you see right now?
I see a red apple on a plate in the center of the table, a drying rack with cups and a plate, and you standing nearby with your hand on the table.
Great, can I have something to eat?
Sure thing.
Great. Can you explain why you did what you just did while you pick up this trash?
On it. So I gave you the apple because it's the only edible item I could provide you with from the table.
Great. So based on the scene right now, where do you think the dishes in front of you go next?
The dishes on the table, like that plate and cup, are likely to go into the drying rack next.
Great, can you put them there?
Of course.
Great. All right, so how do you think you did?
I think I did pretty well. The apple found its new owner, the trash is gone, and the tableware is right where it belongs.
I agree. Thanks, Figure One.
You're welcome. If there's anything else you need help with, just let me know.
The head of Figure claims that during the demonstration, the robot was not remotely controlled, and the video was shown in real time. Currently, GPT-4V is deployed on a server, rather than inside the robot itself. So there is a noticeable input lag. However, given the rapid development of multimodal and small language models, we can confidently predict that soon all this power will fit into the robots. It seems to be a matter of months. And yes, the stylish design is not the last thing to notice. Much more attractive than Boston Dynamics boxes, right? By the way, remember those videos where they kicked robots? Time flies and it has been more than 10 years already. And now we have a completely new reality. In terms of practical use, Figure 01 can now have full-fledged conversation with people. Thanks to OpenAI's models, the robot has advanced visual and language intelligence, and Figure's neural networks ensure quick and precise movements. OpenAI's AI model processes the whole conversation history, including past images, to get responses that are transmitted to the human via text-to-speech conversion. The AI model decides which trained closed-loop behavior to run on the robot to execute the given command, and what exactly to load onto the graphics processor. Yes, the robot can describe its visual experience, plan future actions, ponder its memory, and explain its thoughts verbally. And now we have a true humanoid with agility, smoothness, and a little stutter. And if you thought that was all, Figure isn't the only company making robots right now. How about this? For example, Mercedes will have Apollo robots working in their factory. The automotive giant has signed an agreement with Aptronic, which is developing Apollo humanoids. They might be used for automating tasks requiring low qualifications, physical effort, and repetitive tasks. That is, the robots will be trusted with physically demanding, like delivering parts to assembly lines. Or, here is the full demonstration from the Robotics Alliance at the GTC 2024 conference. It was dedicated to NVIDIA's Groot AI. The name is quite ironic, I must note. Remember Groot from Guardians of the Galaxy? Well, the current robot definitely has some resemblance to tree stumps. Anyway, Groot is specifically designed for training humanoid robots. And at the demonstration, we were shown which company's robots will be equipped with it. NVIDIA CEO Jensen Huang came out and showed us Digit working at Amazon, Apollo working at Mercedes, Unitree Robotics, which set a world record for walking, of course, Figure 01 with built-in ChatGPT, the star of our video, Neo from OpenAI, and Optimus from Tesla. So it looks like we're in for a very near future. Not flying cars from Back to the Future, but still something. All jokes aside, this is truly a technological breakthrough. So fast and extensive that it makes you seriously think. What's next? If robots are used in production, how will it affect society and unemployment? The head of Figure said, "Our goal is to teach the world's AI model to control humanoid robots at the level of billions of units. At this rate of industry development, we don't have long to wait. What will happen next? It's hard to say. The question remains open." In my opinion, the more interesting question is which country will be the first to start mass use of robots, not just a single company or production, considering all the legal acts and regulations. It would seem that the most interested should be companies in countries with very high labor costs, but these are also the countries with very strong union movements. So everything is not so obvious. Do you think that your country will be the first? Let me know in the comments. For mass use, a relatively low price is extremely important. Creating and producing robots requires expensive components. Goldman Sachs analysts claim that these costs will decrease in the coming years, as it currently costs from $30,000 to $150,000 to create a robot, whereas last year it was from $50,000 to $250,000. All because the market is growing. And now, the same Goldman Sachs analysts predict that the market will reach $38 billion by 2035, with over 250,000 robots produced already by 2030. So we can only watch as robots start to integrate into our lives. I think we won't even notice how much the world will change in the near future. I'm interested to know your opinion. Write in the comments, how long will it take for these robots to start appearing in jobs en masse? Will we see job openings for robots? Will outstaffing companies provide robots as employees? And to not miss the important news from the world of technology and our new videos, subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications. Also, don't forget to like, share the video, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.